Hello, myself Soumya, Faculty in Physics, GFGC, Coimbatore, Mysore. Today I am going to explain about the second sum experiment, one of the experiment that is specific heat of cooling. The main aim of the experiment is to find the specific heat of a liquid. The principle used here is the Newton's law of cooling. Firstly, we have to keep in mind about the two things, that is the specific heat and the Newton's law of cooling. Specific heat states that the amount of heat per unit mass required to raise the temperature by 1 degree Celsius is what the specific heat in generally. And the Newton's law of cooling states that rate of cooling is directly proportional to the excess of temperature over the surroundings. This is the two main things which we have to keep in mind. And here the two terms will come, that is heat and temperature. Both are actually are different. Heat is the it is a form of energy, and it is measured in terms of joule, whereas the temperature is the amount of hotness or the coldness of the body. It is measured in terms of degree Celsius. We know that, but both are interconnected. Heat and temperature are both interconnected, but they are not the same. This one we have to keep in mind. Now I am going to explain about the equipments I am using. This is the wooden box where the insulating stuff is placed inside this wooden box, and the calorimeter, this is the stirrer, this is the thermometer, and the stopcock. This is the gas stove which is used to heat the water and the liquid. Okay, now I am going to start the experiment. Before the experiment, some observations we have to note down, that is the mass of the calorimeter and the stirrer used for the water. For this purpose, I am using this calorimeter and the stirrer. I have to take the measurement by using a weighing scale. After taking the measurement of this both calorimeter and the stirrer, I have to pour the water into this calorimeter. After pouring the water to the calorimeter and the stirrer is placed inside that, I have to keep this inside this wooden box and I will close the lid. After closing this lid, I will insert the thermometer into this. After inserting this, it will show some temperature now. At some temperature, that is around when it reaches to 80 degree Celsius. See, now the thermometer is showing around 80 degree Celsius. At this temperature, I will take down the readings now. By every 2 degree fall in temperature, now the temperature shows the 80 degree, and I will start the stopcock. While starting this, by every 2 degree fall in the temperature, we have to note down the readings, that is 80, 78, 76, for every 2 degree fall in the temperature in this wooden box. And we have to note down the time. Then we have to take down the readings up to 40 degree, which is for your head, that's it. Well, then we remove this and take down the value and take down the measurement with the water. Now we have to measure the calorimeter, water, and the stirrer. Okay, that has to be written here. That is M dash W, mass of the container with the stirrer plus the water. This gives the mass of the water taken, that is mass of the calorimeter with the stirrer used for the water minus this mass of the calorimeter with stirrer plus the water will give the mass of the water. This process is repeated for liquid also. Here I am taking the liquid as the castor oil. See, same process will be repeated. Firstly, we have to note down mass of the calorimeter and the stirrer used for the liquid. Again, we have to put this inside this wooden box and start cooling and taking the readings. After that, we have to take down the mass of the calorimeter stirrer with the given liquid. This gives the mass of the liquid taken. That is ML and MW will be noted down. The values will be written here, time for the liquid and time for the water. This is about the tabular column part. After all this, we have to plot a graph. After all this, we have to plot a graph. That is, in the x-axis we are taking the time, and with the y-axis we are taking the temperature as theta, and this is time t. We draw a curve. When we make the points, the curve will be obtained like this. This is for the water, and this curve is for the liquid. For two temperatures, take any two. The two temperatures will be theta 1 and theta 2. Make the difference between these two temperatures will be around 10 degrees Celsius. That is a higher temperature and the lower temperature. When we put a line like this, when we draw a line for the theta 1, it touches both the liquid and the water curve here, and theta 2 will also touches both the liquid and the water curve here. Next, the lines will be cutted like this. See here, T1L represents the temperature where for the liquid line, and T2L will be the for the liquid line itself only. Next, this is for T1W is for this water line, and this is also T2W is also for water line. Here we are seeing that the water curve will be greater than the liquid. This shows that any liquid will be cools very fastly than with the water. This is about the graph, and next we have to take down the readings. T1, T2, here I have shown you in the graph T1 and T2. Next, T1W, here T2W, T1L and T2L. When we take the difference, we get the TW and TL. Here, by using the formula, the SW means the specific heat of the water, and SC means the specific heat of a calorimeter. This is a constant value we are taking here and substituting to the formula. We get some result. The unit for this is joule per kg per Kelvin. This is all about the specific heat of a liquid experiment. Thank you.